Now, let's shift our focus to Nepal, where hospitals are running out of oxygen amid a resurgence in COVID-19 cases. Just this week, five people died of suffocation after a hospital ran out of oxygen. Daily new cases have risen 60-fold since the beginning of April, and nearly 1,000 people have died in the last 10 days. The country is now witnessing severe cases, flooding hospitals, and oxygen cylinders are emptying out faster than they can be refilled.
जनको व्यवस्थापन नै सबभन्दा बढी तनावको चाहिँ विषय बनेको छ र हाम्रो अस्पताल व्यवस्थापनले सकेसम्म अक्सिजन चाहिँ कमी हुन नदिने प्रयत्न गरिरहेको छ यो अक्सिजन सिलिन्डर हामी यो 40 बेड रन गरिरहँदाखेरि हाम्रो 5 बेड 40बाट 5 बेड हामी सेन्ट्रल लाइनबाट चल्दा पनि हामी 35 वटा बेड त अक्सिजन सिलिन्डरबाट चलाएका छौँ.
In the capital Kathmandu, several hospitals have said that they can no longer admit any new patients. Nepal's Prime Minister now faces accusations that he missed a window of opportunity to stem the virus spread. Health officials say that the country is in a crisis.
हामीले यद्यपि सबै देशहरूसँग सबैसँग प्रयासहरू गरेका छौँ ती सहयोगहरू हामीले भने अनुसार उपलब्ध हुन सकेनन् भने हाम्रो अवस्था एकदमै खराब अवस्था एकदमै हामीले व्यवस्थापन गर्न निकै गाह्रो हुने अवस्थातिर जान्छ जस्तो हामीले देखिरहेका छौँ.
The rise in cases can be attributed to the Nepal government removing restrictions earlier in the year. Despite seeing a rise in cases in April, the government continued to allow and even organize large religious festivals and political gatherings. For a better understanding of the situation on ground in Nepal, our correspondent Saloni Murarka has sent us more details in this report. Take a look.
Nepal somehow managed the first wave of coronavirus, but the second wave has been devastating for the country and has taken a toll over the healthcare infrastructure. The virus has so far killed over 4,000 people in the country. In the last 1 month, Nepal has seen a surge in the daily coronavirus cases from 150 to 9,000 cases. Well, many hospitals in the country have said that they won't be able to admit any more COVID patients due to the critical shortage of oxygen. The health ministry itself has said that a hospital will need at least 14,000 to 15,000 oxygen cylinders in a day. But the oxygen plants in Kathmandu can refill only 8,000 cylinders in a day. Well, many private hospitals in the country have even issued statements criticizing the government for providing them with only 100 oxygen cylinders per day. Of course, Nepal has received some help from other countries, but due to the rising coronavirus cases, Nepal is not able to control or treat the infection due to the lack of resources, of course. Saloni Murarka for VON World is One in Lahan, Nepal.
VON World is One is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news updates on the move.